one of the reasons why class has become one of the factors bringing about change in the caste system is because there are various processes of change which are underway. Now, the various processes of change which are underway are broadly westernization, modernization, industrialization, urbanization and Sanskritization. Now, let us look at them one by one. When you talk about westernization, then you are actually talking about a system in which people tend to adopt a western style of living, a western style of dressing, and also your outlook changes, you develop a rational and a scientific outlook, you believe in material progress, you start communicating using mass media, you may also have an English medium education. So, that means what you are therefore saying is that westernization means that now you are no longer able to identify one another on the basis of caste, on the basis of dress, on the basis of speech. If you remember earlier, we had said that speech, dress and language were often associated with a particular caste group, but because of westernization, this has undergone a change. What are the conditions for Sanskritization? The conditions for Sanskritization are, it should be a touchable status, you need to have a better economic status, and typically in order to sustain your claim to Sanskritization, you should be able to justify it on the basis of some myth or story. So, say for example, one of the stories could be that you were running away from some king, and because of which you were forced to hide in the forest for several years. If you were hiding in the forest for several years, in order to sustain yourself, you started working with leather, because of which you became leather workers, or you became people who work with chamda. But in reality, your status is much higher. So, that means now you are able to justify your claim to a higher status based on some story or myth, right? Now, apart from Sanskritization and westernization, change in the concept of the caste system has also come about because of modernization. Now, what does the term modernization mean? The term modernization means that your outlook becomes more rational. It also means that the society as a whole permits greater amount of social mobility. It also means social mobility that is permitted in your society is because of a democratic setup. So, that means you are following the principles of democracy that are liberty, equality and fraternity. And it is not necessary that the term modernization has to be the same as westernization. Modernization may include westernization, but you can also modernize without westernizing. That means you could continue to dress in your traditional way, you could continue to behave as you traditionally did in terms of the kind of food that you eat, but you become modern in your outlook. Other changes that have come about in the caste system are also because of economic and political factors. Because of economic and political factors, what has now happened is that certain castes in some regions have become the dominant caste. Now, the term dominant caste means that they have started dominating over the other caste groups. Now, why has this happened? This has happened because generally what might have happened is that you may have access to larger land holdings. You may belong to a lower caste, but because of, let's say, because of chakbandi, that is because of land consolidation, you have access to larger land holdings. You may also belong to a politically dominant caste. That means people of your caste group also belong to the ruling parties. What might also happen is that you may also have a higher ritual status, you may also have a larger population. So, because of which what happens is that you become the dominant caste. Other changes that have happened are also because of industrialization and urbanization. Now, the factors of industrialization and urbanization have led to the growth of towns and cities, and the growth of towns and cities has now meant that people have started following new kinds of occupations. It has also meant that class becomes the operative term. Now, because you are living in towns and cities, you have migrated from other areas, people sitting next to you, people in your office, people in your classrooms may not know to which caste you belong. The only indication that they may have to your caste is perhaps through your surname, and many of us do not even write a surname anymore. So, that means it is very difficult to identify to which caste you belong. And why has this happened? This has happened because of industrialization and urbanization. See, the process of industrialization is one in which agriculture is now no longer the dominant mode of production. Instead, what happens is you start working in factories. If you are working in factories, that means you are standing next to a person, working next to a person throughout the day without really bothering about his or her caste system, right? So, that means in cities, it is not possible to follow the caste rules to such an extent as you may perhaps have followed them in the earlier times, right? So, that has also greatly diluted the caste system. Now, the government of India very consciously has been trying to do away with the caste system, because as you very well know, there are lots of evils that are associated with the caste system. You have heard of caste based violence, I am sure. You have also heard of the lower caste children not being allowed to sit in classrooms, instead being made to clean out toilets in schools, right? Now, why all of this is illegal? Now, why has this become illegal? All of this has become illegal. The government of India, through its legal process, has introduced various legislations through which untouchability has now become a crime. If untouchability has become a crime, what does this mean? This simply means that you cannot discriminate between people on the basis of their caste. You cannot force people to sit outside classrooms. You cannot force children in schools just because they belong to the lower caste groups to go and clean toilets. All of this makes it illegal. Plus, what the government has also did is there is something called this process of positive affirmation. Now, if you are talking about the process of positive affirmation, that means the government of India has also introduced a system of reservation. Through reservation, very often what you will find is that many of the posts, like let us say for example, the post of the sarpanch is now reserved for the scheduled castes. And you see, the term scheduled caste also means that you are now no longer calling them untouchables. And I am sure you are also familiar with Gandhiji's word Harijan, Harijan meaning people of God. That was also his attempt to mitigate or dilute the impact of the caste system. Now, as I was saying, the government of India has reserved certain posts in the panchayat, including the post of the sarpanch, for the scheduled caste. That means the higher castes who traditionally ruled the society can now no longer aspire to become a sarpanch, can no longer aspire for a position in the village panchayat. It is only the scheduled castes who can become the panchayat members. So, that means caste and class go hand in hand. You know, the other day when I was in a village, what was very interesting for me was I went to the sarpanch's house, and the sarpanch belonged to a lower caste, but he had a very high position in the village because he was the sarpanch meaning the head of the panchayat. And what was further very interesting was that this sarpanch also was a very rich grain merchant, who dealt with grains, who dealt with buying and selling of grains in the neighboring city. So, you see, what have I said? Through this example, I have shown you that it is caste, it is class, and it is also the system of positive affirmation by the government of India, which has now led to the dilution of the caste system, or the caste system has become modernized, right? And I am sure you have also heard of the term OBCs. The term OBC actually deals with other backward classes. That is also a collective term given by the government of India, in which those caste groups which were classically, that means from the earlier times, socially and educationally disadvantaged, were given certain advantages. That means, and this happened because of the Mandal Commission in the 1980s. And I am sure you have heard of OBC reservations, I am sure you have heard of SC reservations, you have also heard of ST reservations. These are all attempts by the government to mitigate the evil effects of the caste system. And today what has happened is that we are interacting with one another, we are talking to one another irrespective of our caste system. So, that means the caste system has undergone a system of change, and today caste is now no longer a criteria which limits your achievement in society. Thank you.